Ladies and gentlemen, implementing agricultural restructuring, over the last year, localities in the province have stepped up the transformation of economic structure. At the same time, there are many mechanisms and policies to encourage and support new production models in the field. As a result, the agricultural models with high economic efficiency are constantly being replicated, making an important contribution to socio-economic development and creating resources for building new style rural areas in the province.
In the last years, the crop structure in the province continued to have a strong shift, reducing the acreage of some plant crops such as rice, sugarcane, and rubber. In the period of 2016-2020 alone, the whole province has converted to 10,000 hectares of rice, rubber, sugarcane, etc. into planting root trees, other crops, and at the same time, clean agriculture, high-tech agriculture such as producing vegetables and root trees according to VGF standards, vegetable production in greenhouses and membrane houses has also developed strongly, contributing to increasing income for people. By the end of 2020, the average product value obtained per 100 of cultivated land of the people in the province reached about 100 million Vietnam dong per year. In Chu Mít Khăm Miếu, Yum Châu District, one of the localities has stepped up crop conversion in the last years, with an area of about 3,000 hectares of agricultural land. Previously, farmers mainly cultivated rice and peanuts. However, in the past 5 years, due to the low economic efficiency of these crops, local people have only converted into growing root trees such as longan, durian, and green-skinned pomelo. Within 3 years from 2017 to 2020, the commune has had more than 700 hectares of paddy land converted into root trees, bringing the total area of root trees in the commune to over 2,000 hectares. As one of the leading households in the transformation of crop structure, Mr. Trần Văn Quang, living in Thuận An Hamlet, Chu Mít Khăm Miếu, said that previously his family had 100 of rice land, but the income was not good. 2 rice crops a year, sometimes it was just break even or the profit was not much after subtracting investment costs. 3 years ago, when he saw that the households in the hamlet converted into growing longan with high income, after learning how to grow and care, Mr. Wang also decided to convert from rice land into longan cultivation. The rice crops in a few years ago was not as good as this longan crop, so the farmers drained their crops. Like last year, in the first harvest, it can reach 6 tons of roots per 50 trees. This year is the second crop, so it means that we can harvest one crop within 2 years. In the third year, we harvest 2 crops. If growing rice, the farmers get only 4 tons per hectare because the soil has no alluvium and earn about 2 million Vietnam dong after deducting on cost. Meanwhile, we can get 6 tons only if the price is 10,000 Vietnam dong per kilogram. It is also 60 million Vietnam dong and profitable to 40 million Vietnam dong after deducting 20 million Vietnam dong. In Cầu Khởi, Commune Yum Châu District, many households now boldly convert crops in which their model of growing bamboo for bamboo sauce is promoting quite high economic efficiency. If bamboo sauce are produced in the previous season, from September of the previous calendar year to April of the following calendar year, the selling price will be from 15,000 to 20,000 Vietnam dong per kilogram. If subtracting the investment cost for taking care of each year, the growers can get profit of about 300 million Vietnam dong per hectare of bamboo sauce growing land. Previously, I planted rubber trees in this land. At that time, I earned 9 or 10 million per month. In 2018, I just started to transfer to grow bamboo sauce. I see that the income from growing it is higher. If growing the rubber trees, it can get 100 million Vietnam dong per hectare per year. While growing bamboo sauce, the income is not less than 300 million Vietnam dong a year.
diện tích đất tự nhiên của xã Cầu Khởi là
The natural land area of Cầu Khởi Camille is more than 3,300 hectares, of which agricultural land is about 1,500 hectares. Regarding the conversion of road structure at present, the ineffective grass and rubber growing areas have been converted into growing durian, jackfruit and bamboo shoots. In general, these crops bring very high economic efficiency to the people, especially bamboo shoots. The conversion of crop structure creates favorable conditions to improve people's income, contributing to social economic development. Currently, the average income per capita of the commune is about 59.28 million Việt Nam đồng per year. Implementing crop restructuring, currently, Tinan Province is reviewing the orientation of crop conversion areas, especially high-value-added crops, developing products that are in great demand domestically and for export, with an area of over 16,700 hectares. In addition, the province also focuses on capital for public investment to develop infrastructure for production conversion areas, especially the system of irrigation, drainage and dikes. Only in the period of 2013-2020, the province focused on investing in 37 new irrigation works with a total cost of 1,661 billion Việt Nam đồng. Some key projects have been completed and put into use, such as Phước Hòa Irrigation, the Biên Irrigation Area, Long Phước A Pumping Station, Hoa Thành Tour, Die Against Floods along Vàm Cỏ River. In particular, the key project of irrigation in the west of Vàm Cỏ Đông River, serving the irrigation for nearly 16,953 hectares of agricultural land, water supply for industrial production, daily life and husbandry for people of Châu Thành and Bến Cầu districts, is speeding up construction progress. In addition, there are also drainage canals of Hội Thành, Tân Phú, Tân Hưng, and actual drainage canals which are invested seriously with rural traffic, creating favorable conditions for people to transport agricultural products with an area of 7,790 hectares belongs to crop conversion projects of three districts of Tân Biên, Dương Minh Châu, and Gò Dầu. Over the past years, the irrigation infrastructure has been gradually invested in a modern and flexible direction, ensuring water supply for people and economic sectors, contributing to improving people's life, ensuring the national water and food security, changing production practices, crop structure, increasing land use coefficients, forming high economic value crop conversion production areas, taking the initiative in irrigation water sources for agricultural production. According to the assessment of the Department of Agriculture and Rural Development, the irrigation for agricultural production of the province by 2020 reached 149,333 hectares. Irrigation system in the commune is invested seriously. Now all canals are converted. Irrigation canals are very convenient. Many dry fields in the past now have canals to carry water back, helping farmers convert crops smoothly. Specifically, the field up giữa hamlet of Thuận Bình Hamlet, cây gõ field in Thuận Hòa Hamlet, nhánh stream field in Thuận Tân Hamlet. Ba Bảo Field in Thuận Tân Hamlet. At present, the commune has coordinated with the superior authorities to build a system of roads along the canals and then pull electric lights for farmers so that they can serve for irrigating crops. In order to promote development of agricultural production, especially to restructure crops and animals, in the period of 2021-2025, the province will continue to implement the approved master plans and orientations suggest development of high-tech agricultural production areas, planning for irrigation development, at the same time arrangement of some agricultural companies, orientation of some areas of converting production models to build specialized farming areas to develop raw materials for export and processing. At the same time, it will also attach importance to reorganizing production towards safety and value chain to focus on developing areas for production of specialized fruit trees, custard apple, banana, mango, pomelo, pineapple, etc., towards export or as raw materials for export processing. As for traditional crops, such as sugarcane, cassava, rice, etc., it continues to increase added value towards intensifying intensive farming, synchronous mechanization, increasing productivity, quality, lowering production costs to ensure raw materials for the processing industry to partially develop in an organic direction to increase product value. In addition, the province also reviewed the land fund of agricultural companies to create a clean land fund so that it can attract businesses to invest in development in agriculture with high technology, clean agriculture, organic agriculture, attracting development of agricultural production, helping farmers assess and understand the application of high-tech agriculture so that they can change from traditional farming to clean agriculture.
Ladies and gentlemen, changing the structure of land and animal to suit the characteristic of its locality is one of the necessary and important conditions. It's enabling farmers to explore all available advantages and increase their income, improve life in order to help people improve the quality of life and development sustainable household economy. And now the state program is building a new countryside broadcasting on the radio and television station. Robert, thanks for watching and goodbye for now.